again, welcome to my new studio space as I navigate my way around my property, finding quiet little spaces to practice from. So this morning, I'm not sure what we're going to do. I think I'll make it up as we go along. I haven't kind of woken up with any ideas today or feeling in a particular way, which sometimes is quite nice. You kind of get to explore the world as it comes, living in the moment, instead of starting the day with a particular goal or ambition in mind, just kind of being in the space in the moment. So I invite you to be in the moment today. I'm going to start by sitting up nice and tall, gently closing your eyes. You can take a mudra with the hands if it feels comfortable. Otherwise, you can just raise the hands to the knees. And take a few deep breaths. Settling into your body. Settling into your breath. And slowly start to deepen and lengthen your breath. Breathing right from the base of the diaphragm into the intercostal muscles between the ribs. Even feeling the gentle rise and fall of the clavicles. And the sternum. So that we're utilizing all of the respiratory muscles. Feeling each little alveoli of the lung blow up with the inhale and release with the exhale. Just practicing mindful observation of breath, of body, of thoughts, and your overall sense of well-being. Slowly lower your chin to your chest and hold here as you let your head become heavier and heavier, sliding the shoulders gently away from the ears. And then on your next inhale, moving one ear over to one shoulder. And let your head become heavy, dropping to the side. Lower back down, chin to chest. And then over to the other shoulder. Lowering back down, chin to chest. And then inhale to lift the face up and turn the gaze up towards the sky. Keep the back of the neck long, and then start to push your lower jaw out. And coming back to center. Lightly holding onto the front of your knees. As you inhale, you're going to lean forward, opening up the heart, opening up the throat. And then as you lean back, you round into the spine and really lift into the pubic bone. Inhale to rock yourself forward. Draw the shoulder blades back. Exhale to round, curling into the spine. Open the shoulder blades apart. Inhale to open up through the heart and the throat. Stick the tailbone out and squeeze your back muscles. Exhale to round. Inhale, coming forward. And then it starts to take us into a side movement as well, coming into a full circle. So still working into that cat-cow alignment, but now also getting the side body into a flexion and extension pattern. Lengthening into one side as the other side compresses. Change the direction of your circle around. And then inhaling, coming back to center. Let's float the hands up to the sky. And then lengthen as tall as you can from crown to tail. Soften the shoulders, but reach the fingers up. On your exhale, breath twisting to one side. Inhale to lift. And exhale, twisting to the other side. Inhale to lift. Let's exhale, bring the hands down in front of you and then roll over your hands and your knees, coming into tabletop. Point your toes in tabletop so the tops of your feet are flat. We're going to inhale, cow pose, exhale, cat, stay in cat, inhale, knees up, exhale, knees down. Inhale, cow, exhale, cat. Keep the toes pointing, knees up, and exhale, knees down. Inhale, cow, exhale, cat. Inhale, knees up, exhale, knees down. Flow with your own pace. Last round, finishing off, and then coming back into tabletop. You're going to reach out the right arm and the left leg, and then floating off the mat. Kick your heel away, reach your fingertips forward. And then on the inhale breath, you can reach back to hold onto the foot and kick the foot up to the sky. Inhale to extend and exhale to release. Taking up the left arm and right leg and then floating up into balance. Square the hips, reach the head forward, reach the tailbone back. And then bringing your hand behind you, holding onto the foot as you kick the leg up to the sky.
to extend and exhale to release. Taking the right arm open to the side, open up the chest and then thread your arm under, lowering onto your right shoulder. Press all five fingernails of the right hand into the mat and then slide your left hand forwards. You're on the fingertips, gently opening up the shoulder, opening up the heart, keeping the hips and the knees square. You have the option of taking this deeper if you feel that that's appropriate for your body, or if you feel like holding into the space and just staying in the moment, I invite you to do that today. Come back up into tabletop by rebending the left arm and then floating the right hand under the shoulder. Inhale, taking left arm up. And exhale to thread. Taking right fingertips in front and then roll the shoulder blade back, open up through the heart. And then inhale, coming back, hand under shoulder, into tabletop. You can bring the hands one space forward, tucking toes, and lifting the hips up and back into downward facing dog with the knees deeply bent. Let's shake your head, yes. Shake the head, no. And then heel toe the feet up and down, stretching through the backs of the hamstrings. Lifting right up onto the tippy toes of the bent knee to work over the ankle and toe joints. And then start to twist this as well. So as you bend one knee, turn the gaze away from that leg and then to the other side, looking underneath the arm so that the neck is in a comfortable space. And sink both heels towards the floor as you lift the hips up and back, and then looking between the hands, take little steps coming forward, lifting the chest into flat back, hands to the shoulders. Reach the head forward, reach the tailbone back. Let's exhale to forward fold. Lift the shoulders to allow the neck to lengthen. On the inhale breath, taking the hands all the way up to the sky. And exhaling hands to heart. Standing into your Tadasana, lift the toes off the mat and then anchor down through the big toe mound, the baby toe mound, and the point of the heel, so that there's a triangle in the foot. Lifting the sole of the foot up and feel how that lifts the knees, lifts the thighs, and grows the spine tall. Rest the toes back down now. Inhale the hands to the sky. And exhale to forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. And exhale to fold. Inhale the right leg into lunge and lift open through the heart, sinking the hips low. Going to step forward again. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, taking the hands all the way up. And exhaling hands to heart. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold. Inhale, left leg back into lunge. Sink the hips low, lift the chest high. Breathe into the space. Stepping forward, flat back. Open the heart, exhale to fold. Inhale, circle sweep the hands all the way up. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, right leg lunge. And then drop the back knee to the mat. Open up through the chest, fingers light on the floor. Sink your hips a little bit lower as you float the heart up a little bit higher. On your inhale, breath, lifting the back knee and stepping forward, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweeping up. And exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, left leg lunge, and dropping the back knee to the mat, opening up through the finger, through the chest, as your fingertips very lightly touch the floor. Sink your hips a little bit lower, lift the chest a little bit higher, and then inhale, take a step forward, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reaching arms all the way up, and exhaling hands to heart. Inhale, arms up, lightly holding onto the left wrist and leaning over to the right side. Push your hips out a little bit as you gently pull into your upper arm. Inhale to the center, switch the hands around and gently pulling to the opposite side. Hips square with chest open. Inhale to the center and then reach the hands behind you, interlocking fingers. Bend the elbows to get the palms to touch, and then as you draw the shoulder blades together, the arms start to straighten. You're going to squeeze your thighs really intensely, really engage into the glutes, and then start to curl the upper body, lifting the chest. Don't go too deep and be mindful of the lower back. You're now going to soften your knees quite a lot as you forward fold, allowing the arms to hang over the back body. Let your head, neck and shoulders drip down to the earth. Drop the hands to the floor. We're going to inhale the right leg into lunge and then exhale to drop the back knee to the mat. Inhale, lifting arms to the sky. Slide the hips forward, open the heart. Let's draw the hands together at the chest, and then opening into warrior two arms, bringing right arm forward, left arm back. So you're twisting towards your inner thigh, stretching those arms. Let's inhale, hands at the heart. Warrior two arms to the opposite side. Left arm forward, right arm back. But square the hips here. Turn your gaze forward. Bring the back hand to the thigh and lift the front arm up. Slide the hips down as you reach the fingertips overhead. From here, cartwheel the hands back down to the mat. And then inhale, lifting the back knee to step into plank. Holding into your plank as you find lightness in the body. Let's lower knees, chest, and chin. And then slide down to the tummy, bringing the fingertips out wide, opening up through the heart into wide cobra. Use the back muscles. And allow the fingertips just to lightly press into the floor. Release all the way down, hands under shoulders, and slide into child's pose. On your next exhale, downward facing dog. If you still need to take movement, please feel free to do so. If you're ready to hold into stillness, then find that space in your down dog and connect to your breath. on the inhale, take the right leg to the sky. And then exhale, knee to face, face to knee. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, knee to face, face to knee. Look between the hands and lightly step your foot down into lunge. Inhale, forward, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale the arms all the way up to the sky. And exhaling hands to heart. Take a moment in your Tadasana, breathing here. If you want to lift the toes off the mat again and find those three points of the triangle, lift into the arch of the foot. Engage the thighs, the knees, lengthening the spine. Let's release the toes down. Inhale, arms up. And exhale to hold onto one elbow as you lean to the side. Draw the shoulder blade back down a little bit. Open the chest a little bit. Inhale, center, switching over to the other side. Find a comfortable space for your neck. Inhale to center, bring the hands behind you, interlocking fingers, bend the elbows, getting the palms to touch, and then roll the shoulder blades together to open up through the heart. Let's start to take it into a bit of a back bend, be mindful here, opening the front body without collapsing the back. Lift back up tall and then soften the knees to forward fold. Dropping hands to the mat and stepping your left leg back into lunge. Let's lower the back knee down and then inhale the hands up to the sky. Stretching into the hip flexor and into the psoas muscle of that left side without compressing the lower back. Hands together at the heart. We'll open into warrior two arms, left arm forward, right arm back. And then inhale to the center, turning left arm back, right arm forward. Square the hips a little bit here. Turn your gaze forward, bringing the back hand to the thigh and reaching the top arm up to the sky. Lengthen into the lower back and really open the front body. Let's cartwheel the hands down to the floor, lifting the back knee to step into plank. Engage into lower belly, lowering knees, chest, and chin. Inhaling down to the floor, fingers open wide to the side as you lift into wide cobra. Point the toes behind you. Let's exhale to release down. Hands under the shoulders, sliding into child's pose. And then lifting up and back, downward facing dog. Finding your stillness in your down dog. Opening the shoulder blades. Turning the biceps to go forward. Don't take those monkeys too seriously. On your inhale breath, let's take the right leg up to the sky. And then exhale, knee to face, face to knee. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, knee to upper right arm. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, knee to upper left arm. Inhale, lifting up. And then exhale, knee to face before stepping the foot down into lunge. On your inhale breath, floating the right hand to the sky. Turn your ribs and your thighs towards one another. And then take the top arm over the ear, reaching it forward before placing it down to the inside of the foot. You're going to rotate yourself to face sideways on your mat, bringing your heels in line and your toes parallel. Lift open through the heart. And then as you exhale, walk your hands forward into a wide downward facing dog. Really focus on releasing your upper body, letting your head slowly drop towards the earth. This is a mixture of down dog and melting heart pose. Notice where you're holding tension and try to let that go. On your inhale, walk your hands back in underneath the shoulders. Reach your head forward as you reach your tailbone back. And then float your hands up to your hips. Push your hips behind you as you reach your head forward. Engage into the inner thighs and the tummy to hold. On your inhale, lift all the way up. And then turning the right foot forward, warrior two. Adjust your alignment as you need to. Sliding your front thigh down and then open the thighs away from one another. So you feel as though the inner thigh is spiraling to sit at the top of the leg. On your inhale breath, reaching forward to come into Paschimottanasana, Vikranasana, elbow to thigh. And the top arm floating past the face to reach over your ear. You have the option of going deeper here if you'd like to this morning. Feel how your body is asking to be moved. And then everyone coming into a half bind. Float the hand up, turn the palm back, and then bring your hand either into your lower back, into your hip, or into your inner thigh. Open up the chest here without letting the front knee roll inwardly. Keep your half bind as you float the front arm up and back into reclining warrior pose. On your inhale, straighten the front leg, one heel, one toe of the back foot, and then reaching forward into a bound triangle, half bound triangle, Adho Mukha Trikonasana. Use the half bind and the top shoulder to create space and openness. Keep your neck in a comfortable position. On your inhale breath, look down at the front big toes. Keep the half bind, soften your front knee, and then reach your fingertips about 10, 20 centimeters in front of the baby toe, sliding the back foot up into your Adho Chandrasana. Half moon balance. Kick your heel away from your head. Reach your head away from your heel. Get lighter and lighter into that supporting front hand. One more deep breath. And then release your hand, release your foot into forward fold at the front of the mat. Let's inhale halfway up, flat back. And exhale to forward fold. Bend your knees as you sweep the hands into Utkatasana. Lifting open through the heart. Turn the thumbs slightly out so that you're opening the shoulder blades. Squeeze your inner thighs. On the exhale, coming down Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And then walk, step, or hop yourself through a vinyasa of your choice. Meeting back in downward facing dog. Find your stillness in your down dog. full body engagement. Let's inhale the left leg to the sky. Exhaling, knee to face, face to knee. Inhale to lift. Exhale to left upper arm. And right onto the toe, the supporting foot. Inhale, lift. Exhale, right upper arm. Inhale, lift. And then move through knee to face as you step the foot down into lunge. Opening up through the heart here. Sink the hips a little bit lower. Keeping the right hand down as you take the left arm up. Become very light in your supporting limbs and turn the chest open. Take the top arm over the ears, stretching it forward before placing it down to the inside of the foot. Let's rotate to face the center line of the body, turning the toes parallel, heels on the same line. Lift your chest open here, coming into a forward fold this time by walking the hands flat and then lifting your head to the sky as you reach your tailbone to the sky. Sorry, head to the earth rather, and tailbone to the sky. Lift the shoulders away from your ears and tilt the weight forward onto the front of the feet. Don't lift the heels, but just become light into the heels. Squeeze inner and outer leg evenly. Let's inhale, back up, hands under the shoulders into a flat back. Bring the hands to the hips, reach your head forward, reach your tailbone back, and then lifting up using the inner thigh and tummy to lift. Turn to your left foot, warrior two. Opening those inner thighs out nice and wide. Find lightness in the upper body and engagement into the lower. Coming forward into Parsvakonasana, sweeping the back arm over your ear. Feel free to go as deep as you'd like to. Just remembering that we're going to come into the half bind, so make sure you've got space for that. Taking the top arm behind the back into the lower back, the waist, or the inner thigh. Stay in your half bind as you sweep the front arm up, reclining warrior. Let's inhale the front leg straight, bring the hand forward, one heel, one toe of the back leg, and then coming down into Ardha Buddha Trikonasana. Notice the difference between the two sides of the body. And then adjust according to the body's needs. Moving into our half moon balance by looking at the front big toe, float the fingertips quite far forward of the baby toe and lifting the back leg up. Turn your raised toes perpendicular to the earth. Open up the chest, open up the heart. Get lighter and lighter into the supporting fingers. From here, let's release the hand, release the leg, coming back into forward fold at the front of the mat. Inhale, chair pose, bend your knees, lifting the arms. Make sure you're in a neutral spine into the lower back. And then from your chair pose, reach your hands forward. And we're going to come to sit down on the mat. So you very slowly curl yourself down. Really feel the engagement of the quads. Tuck the lower back slightly as you can. See if you can keep your hands off the floor. And all the way down. Extend your legs out in front of you and forward fold. Inhale to lift up,
bending into your right knee, and then placing the foot down for Janu Shirsasana. Square your hips towards the front edge of the mat, and keep your front foot engaged against your imaginary wall. Let's inhale, and then exhale to forward fold.
Square the shoulders, lengthen the left side of the torso, and remember, it doesn't matter where your hands reach. We're not aiming to get the hands to the foot. We're aiming to square the ribcage and then lengthen the chest towards the shins. On your inhale, come back up to sit.
And then open your bent knee a bit wider. So now the hips are moving open, so they're no longer parallel to the front edge of the mat. Coming into Janu Shirsasana B, the rotated variation,
bending your elbow to the inside of your extended leg, taking the top arm overhead. Remember, this is a twisting pose, so you're going to twist the bottom ribcage towards the sky. Take your top elbow a little bit further behind the head if you can. Make sure you're in a comfortable space for your neck. Let's inhale to come back up to center. Going to face forward again, squaring off the hips. And then taking your front foot to the outer edge of the straight leg. Lifting up as tall as you can, squeeze your knee into your ribs. And lift your ribs into your thigh at the same time, opening the chest. On your exhale breath, twist towards your inner thigh, placing the right hand lightly behind your back.
Make sure you're sitting upright and not leaning backwards. A good indicator is what's happening with the shoulders. If they're more or less the same height, you know you're in the right space. Let's inhale to the center again, and you're now going to take the straight leg and bend it, placing your heel next to your hip. So not under, but next to. Take the top foot and face it behind you. So we're sitting into Gomukha Asana, or cow-faced pose. Depending on what's happening in your shoulders, you can either just simply forward fold, or if you'd like to, you can take your right hand behind your back, and then help to work that right hand a little bit further up, reaching the fingertips towards the neck. Left hand can come over, interlocking the fingers. If you can't grip your fingers, you can hold onto your shirt. Make sure your neck is free, and then forward fold. Inhale to lift yourself back up to center. Unwrap the hands and then bring your hands behind you. Start to open up your chest here. So you're lifting your heart, squeezing the shoulder blades together. We're now going to shift your legs into Navasana. So maybe walk the fingers a little bit further back. Keep the straight angle in the spine and then float your knees into Navasana. You can keep the hands behind you, creating a bit of balance, or you can sweep the fingers up, engage into your lower belly. Make sure you're not rounding your lumbar spine here. You're lifting onto the sitting bones. Breathe deeply. And we're going to move this into a forward fold, a seated forward fold. So you extend your legs away from you. You lift your arms up. As you now pendulum the legs down, floating the spine up and forward.
Paschimottanasana. And inhale, back up to sit.
Let's take the left knee into the chest and then place your foot to the inner thigh. The hips are square to the short edge of the mat. Lift your spine as you come forward into Janu Shirsasana A.
Be mindful what's happening with your shoulders. Be mindful what's happening with your ribs. Don't be tempted into ignoring all the nuance of this pose just to try and get that leg straighter or to fold deeper. Make sure that you are working with the correct alignment. Let's inhale back up to center, taking this into Janu B by taking the bent knee further out and folding towards the inside of your straight leg. Rotate your shoulder open, rotate the elbow a little bit further back, and feel how that places extra stretch over the ribcage. On your inhale breath, coming back to center, square the hips to face forward again, draw your knee into your chest. Let's place the foot to the outer edge of the thigh, and then sitting up tall, check your front foot is against this imaginary wall. You're lifting your top knee and you're lifting your rib cage, so they're folding in towards one another, creating lift into the lower back. You're going to twist towards the inner thigh, so you're wrapping your right arm in front of the shin, left hand behind. And then grow the spine upright and use the small muscles around the rib cage to twist. Let's inhale back to the center, shifting into Gomukha Asana, bending your straight leg, placing the top foot to face back. So you're stacking your knees one on top of the other. Make sure you're not sitting onto your heels. And again, you can just simply forward fold, or if you'd like to, we'll take the left hand behind the back, and you can help manipulate that hand a bit deeper, right arm up and over, interlocking fingers, make sure your neck is free, and then gently forward fold. Inhale to lift back up to center, and wrapping into the arms, bring the hands behind you, lift open through the chest. Lift your neck, keep the back of the neck long. And then shifting this into Navasana, you can walk the hands a little bit further back, float the knees up into Navasana, really engage through the core. Can float the hands forward if that feels appropriate. And then this time we're going to come down into low boat pose. So coming to rest on the lower back, feet floating, chest floating. Let's exhale back up, high boat. Two more times. One more. And then for the last one, coming down to lie, slowly, all the way onto your back. Bend your knees, hip distance parallel. Make sure the heels are quite close into your sitting bones. So we're in our half bridge pose alignment. Let's roll the shoulder blades into the mat. Lengthen into the spine. Very slightly lifting just the tailbone off so the lower back feels flat. Let's curl the hips up to the sky, dynamically rolling three times. So inhale to lift, and then exhale to lower back down. And feel as though you can create a wave into your spine as you do this. Some days the spine feels very flexible and wavy, and other days it feels a little bit more locked. So just be mindful of how you're feeling today in this moment. Don't worry about how easy this was in another class or how challenging this was in another class. Simply exist in this moment noticing how you're feeling today. And then for the next one, we're going to lift up and hold. Walk your shoulder blades underneath the back, interlocking fingers. And float those hips up to the sky. Remember to keep the core activation, so the knees press towards each other. They don't touch, but they press inward. The big toe side of the foot anchoring down. Open up the shoulders and slowly roll your back down. Curl into the tailbone as you lower and then come into restorative pose. Into a second round, bringing the hands next to the hips, feet hip distance parallel. On your inhale, breath curling the tailbone up. Walk the shoulder blades under the back. You can interlock your fingers. You can place your hands underneath your hips, or you can simply keep the hands flat on the floor, whatever works for you. Wherever you are, we're working on lengthening that front body. So for some of you, you need to focus on opening the chest. For others, you need to focus on opening your psoas muscle, which runs from the spine to the top of the femur. For others, maybe it's the hip flexors across the front of the thigh. So wherever you're feeling tight, send energy into that space. Notice the difference between when you engage the glutes and when you relax them. Both options is fine. Work with the one that works for your body. Let's slowly curl down. Open the shoulder blades before you roll. Upper, middle, lower, sacrum, tailbone. Restorative pose. Use a restorative pose as an opportunity to reconnect. Connecting to body. Connecting to breath. Now let's take one final round. You can take a half bridge pose, or you can come into a wheel if you know that your spine is ready for that. You're going to float your arms up if you're coming into the wheel. Hands underneath the shoulders with the fingers pointing to the toes. Either way, make sure you're honoring and respecting your body. Five of your own breaths. When you're ready to come down, you curl the spine, tuck the chin to the chest, lowering upper, middle, lower, sacrum, tailbone. This time let's take the knees into the chest. Little gentle roll from one side to the other. Massaging out your spine. And then start to wrap your hands as far down the shins as you can, lifting your head towards your knees. Tuck your chin in, and now lift your tailbone up so you're rounding into your back, coming into a teeny tiny little ball. And then you're going to release your head, release the tailbone nice and flat. And shifting the feet into happy baby. So your Anandabalasana, if you can't open the feet comfortably, You can bring the big toes to touch and open the knees wide. Lift your heels and draw the shoulder blades back down into the spine. If it feels good, you can do a gentle roll from side to side. And then coming to the center again, pull one heel into the midline as you extend the other heel away. Your leg doesn't have to be totally straight, just as straight as you can manage. And then over to the other side, extending the opposite leg. Keep pushing the bent knee open wide. And then returning to the center, hugging the knees into the chest. If you need to roll onto your side to sit, please do that. Otherwise, we're going to rock and roll. Rounding into the back. Don't go past the top of the shoulder blades. And then all the way up and stepping yourself back into downward facing dog. From your down dog, bring the knees to the floor and then bring the elbows to the floor. Let's cross the hands to hold onto the outer edge of the upper biceps. Bring the fingers together again. You can just keep the fingers nice and long here so that we're not gripping and creating tension. Moving into dolphin pose. We're going to lift your knees off the mat. If you find this very challenging, open your feet quite wide. If you want more challenge, bring the feet closer together. And either way, bringing the feet towards the head is going to increase intensity. Slide your hips up and back. Make sure your neck is nice and soft. If you want to play around taking one leg up, you can. Make sure you switch the legs around, holding for an equal amount of time, and lower, and then let's drop the knees down to the floor and come to rest into child's pose. You can choose the knees apart or the knees together, but I'd like you to bring your hands next to your hips. And then from here, start to lift yourself back up to center. Swing the hips one side, the feet the other, and then out in front of you. Slowly lowering down through a core roll to the mat. Coming into eagle twist, arms to the side, wrapping right thigh over left, and then dropping the knees to the left. Close your eyes here, take a lovely big breath in, and sigh the breath out. Inhale, return to center, switch the legs around, breath in. And exhale to twist. Completely release and surrender into the space. Inhale, back to center, unwrap the legs, hugging the knees into your chest. And then releasing into Shavasana. Make whatever adjustments you need to spread and support the body. Keeping in the moment by staying connected to your breath. So often in our shavasana we start to drift off towards a place of sleep. That's fine, but you get a better connection and a better sense of relaxation when you stay present in the body. Through the different parts of the body, releasing tension, creating softness, we help to open up blocked energy channels. At some points in the body we can feel tension, but it's not quite a muscular tension, but we can feel it regardless. And sometimes that is us being able to connect to the prana in the body and being observant of the fact that we need to try and release that space, allowing the energy to flow freely, the blood and the lymphatic system to flow freely. Creating balance and harmony. Slowly starts to deepen and lengthen your breath. Feeling your belly rise and fall. Gently running your thumb over each fingertip. Moving your toes, your ankles and wrists. Drawing the feet together and extending the arms overhead. Taking a deep, energizing stretch as you yawn or sigh. Bending your knees and rolling onto your right side. Keeping your eyes softly closed as you lift into a comfortable seated position. Drawing your hands together at your heart center. Stay in the moment, in the body, in the breath. We'll close the class by chanting Om once and Shanti three times. Taking a deep breath in. Oh.
opens to your third eye. The light in me sees and honors the light in you. Lowering your hands to your lips, to your heart, to your mat. Bowing forward in recognition of your practice. Blinking eyes open.